Spiegel arrived at the foundation in 2011. His mother had been killed by a car and he was too young to survive without her. He was confident and strong, despite having the worst possible start to life. In fact, he wanted to be involved in everything that went on around him. He was getting stronger every day, and we wanted to find a surrogate mother for him. If we could get another monkey to raise him for us, he'd stand a much better chance at a natural life. We decided to try him with ex-pet Chico, one of several monkeys living together in an outdoor enclosure. Chico was amazing and adopted Spiegel without hesitation. She watched out for him as he learned to climb. And she introduced him to some of her friends in the troop. With Chico to look out for him, Spiegel fitted in perfectly. He grew into a healthy, happy juvenile, and he and Chico are every bit as close as they've always been. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Spiegel isn't the only orphan in the troop. Ayla's mother was shot by a farmer on a banana plantation. Orphans, expats, and road traffic victims arrive at the foundation every year. As many as possible are released back into the wild. Adult males can fend for themselves, but females and younger monkeys need to be returned to their own troop. Once we found I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between, with only two, just me and you. Not so many things we got to do, but places we got to be. Sit beneath the man's tree. Do you need to
go home? Yeah. Okay.
Some monkeys that are brought in are too humanized to return to the wild, like Mistletoe, who was raised with a group of kittens. Or Scully, whose mother was shot during a hunting safari. Or Forrest, who's deaf and suffers from brain damage and wouldn't survive in the wild. When Frances arrived at the foundation after being kept as a pet for the first year of her life, it was obvious straight away that she had some serious psychological problems. There was real concern that her trauma might be so severe that she would never recover enough to be able to socialize with other monkeys. But then she met Scully. The two of them got on amazingly well, and Frances adjusted quicker than any of us could have anticipated.
What I ask of you won't bring you back to start. 'Cause all I know is who I claim to be. A robber and a banker, a matchbox and a tree.
Her relationship with Scully and the other juveniles in his troop gave her the confidence to step outside her integration cage and start exploring the enclosure that would be her home. Most vervets are accomplished climbers by the time they're 3 months old. Frances arrived at a year old with no climbing abilities whatsoever, but that's all changed. Rehabilitating monkeys isn't easy, and none of this would be possible without the constant hard work of volunteers and local staff. The work that they do carries on day in and day out, even when things are at their toughest. And the reason we do it? To give these animals the best life possible.
Simple times and simpler.